Pick up and quickie! The term crow epistemology was coined by Ayn Rand, but she didn't originate the concept or even contribute significantly to it. It was primarily the work of George Miller. The idea is that humans can deal with small numbers, but can't deal with larger numbers with precision. We can handle one of something, or even two of something. Most of us can handle five, and some can even handle seven or nine without grouping. But there's a limit. When there's a small number that isn't immediately obvious with precision, it's a few. Then there's several, many, a lot, a whole lot, a truckload, and so on. The concept is properly known as subitizing, and there are cognitive models showing the limitations of our brains to deal with larger and larger numbers. Astrophysicists understand this problem very well. They deal in such large distances like the distance to the moon of 240,000 miles, or the distance to the nearest star to our sun of 23.8 trillion miles, or the speed of light, which is 670 million miles per hour. Not only do they find it difficult to describe such magnitudes in context to the public, they know full well the impossibility of conceiving of it themselves. It's also why it's difficult to get people riled up about the national debt, which as of this quickie's writing is about $28.6 trillion. People can kind of understand the 28, but the trillion is so big as to be meaningless. Cognitively, you just discard it. It's why 18th century scholar Bielby Porteous said that one death is a tragedy, but a million deaths is a statistic. Numbers sanctify the crime. Ah, why will kings forget that they are men? He did have a point. I always thought it was weird that we consider duels barbaric when the only people at risk are willing participants, but we still glorify war in which thousands or even millions die. The big number means we just don't have the same attachment to it. That's why it's important to put a human face on things. It's also why it's important to trust the numbers and don't let our feelings get in the way.